Hello, welcome to our channel for R programming. In this video, we will talk about S3 class in R. So what is S3 class? So S3 class, our S3 class system is the R object-oriented programming mechanism. So with S3, different objects can have different methods when using a function, so-called a generic function. So for example, if we want to print a data frame, then R will use the specific methods which defined for the class data frame for the print function. And if you want to print a matrix, R will automatically use the default print methods for the matrix class, because matrix has not been written as a with that specific methods with the print function. So next we will show from the beginning of some objects step by step to understand what is S3 class and how we can use this system. So first we create a matrix called MGX1. Very simple with 6 elements. So we can see this is a matrix, 2 rows, 3 columns. Then any object in R can be assigned with some attributes if you want. So we just show matrix attributes. So you can see this matrix has information and attributes dim, so dimension. This is default. And we can also show the class of this matrix. Just to use class function. So its class is a matrix or an array type. These two are class type defined in R. And next we set a matrix called names to this matrix. Then we show again attributes of this object. So now the name is an attribute. So this is quite simple. You can set any attribute. Next we create a data frame called df1. With the same information elements, but this is a data frame. And we can set an attribute called images with 6 elements to this data frame. Then we show attributes of this data frame. So you can see the data frame's attribute is name, class, row name, and images. So these two different objects have different attributes, right? And if you want to show the individual attributes, you can also use attr function. So it's no problem, which is assigned by ourselves, right? Then we can also show the class of df1. It's a data frame. So next we will show several functions. This is a function called print.dataframe. So this is the function's definition. Very long, we will not see the details. Just to know this is a function. This is also called a method, because print is a generic function. So different class after this generic function, this is called a method. So this method is the specific function for the print, which will be used for the data frame class. Simple, right? So we can also show, for example, print factor. It's different from print.dataframe. It's only for the factor type attributes, for object. And if we show print matrix, so I will show not found, because there is no method called print matrix defined. So which means if you want to print a data frame, I will use this function, print.dataframe. But if you want to print a matrix, I will use print default method, because matrix has no specific message connected with the class matrix for the function print, right? So these two basic idea for S3 class. We can also show, for example, methods print. So they are long, about 269 different all the methods. So this method all be used for different classes. You can see there over 200 class right? Different class, because many class is defined for specific module like GLM, linear regression LM, right? Generalized linear module. So because this also writes the package for the GLM and LM, they will define specific class for the object for the result. So they will use print summary function of this object for the different format, right? So this is quite understandable. And we can also show the methods which are used for the class factory, for example. So in the factory, you can find the print generic function. So which means for the print function, R has written a specific method for the factory type. So this method will be print.factory. And we can also show the methods for the class data frame. Of course, print stay here. So there's also a method called print.dataframe. So this is what we have seen, right? But if you show the method for the class matrix, you see no print here. That's why if we want to print a matrix, I will use the default method for the print for the matrix, because no print.matrix method written here. So after we have this knowledge, what we can do next for the S3 class, so say we will define a new class for the DF1. So we define class is test. Then we can show the class of DF1. So now DF1 is not a data frame, it is a test. Its class is a test. We don't care what is a test, but what we can do, for example, print now DF1, because we have defined a function called print test here. Print test is quite easy, just to print a message. So print test, we want to show it's different. So now we print DF1. Because its class is test now. So I will find the print.test method which we have defined here. So the result is a message. It's not a data frames information. Right? So we hope from this simple example you will know the mechanism of S3. So for example, if you want to create your own package, own object, you can define a new class with any name, not has any confusion with existing names in R. Then you can define new function, maybe not print, maybe for a summary. So summary dot this class name, then write a long statement in function to do your own specific job. Thanks for watching.